And it forms to one thing, Captain Planet. I'm on my packing cannons to crack Atlantis. It's so incredible. Looking at your face is so regrettable. Better fix your mother, gotta rush you to the medical
doctor.
Plugging out like Flick versus Hopper. Untouchable to any window shopper. Mannequin, throw scorch the benches like Stanikin. Smoking cannon is where in the jungles that I'm handling. Like, who brings a composition to the competition? There's gonna be some consequences when I'm. Now let me turn it to the judge and throw the book out. They're skewing on the Barbie like a cookout. This rhyme is.
Coming up next, it's a UFC heavyweight division collision. Folks, fasten your seatbelts. This could end up being a very technical, very entertaining fight. I'm surprised they didn't bring out the gis for this one, Champ.
I mean, you would have thought as a jiu-jitsu watcher that you would see these two competitors at a jiu-jitsu competition. But ultimately, they are meeting in the octagon, and you are about to see jiu-jitsu in the UFC like we've never seen before.
Oh, big knee! Some excellent ground and pound strikes here, DC. There's an efficiency with which he operates in these situations.
He knows exactly when to throw, exactly when to hold, and it's allowing him to really control the grappling aspect of the fight.
There's a song there, right? Yes. Know when to hold him.
Know when to fold him. Yep, absolutely. Big kick.
Big knee there to the chest. Nice hook. He lands there. Oh! Now goes in and secures the takedown. All right, working inside the closed guard now. Gets the elbow up into the target. All right, DC, half guard position here. You've done a lot of good work in this spot in your career.
Oh, man, I love this position. And you see this fighter today loves it too. It is the most secure position in fighting. You get an underhook on one side, you keep a half guard on the other, and then you just go to work. It's the safe. Oh, man, look at that. Picture perfect. Got to the leg, got to his position, got another beautiful takedown.
Just over 3 minutes to go now.
Oh, big elbow.
Reversal here, DC.
What a way to switch the position. Fantastic movement by the bottom fighter.
Bottom fighter trying to control posture, unable to do so.
And now he's in a lot of danger. He's got to grab that head or he's going to get blasted.
That's got to be discouraging as he gets right back up again. And he lands a big left hand there. His misses are in.
Big kick lands.
It's a huge shot there, DC. I'm not sure how he stayed up with it.
I mean, when you get hit with a shot like that, to stay standing, show, and talk to your toughness.
Oh, and he lands another leg kick there. He's already landed several in this round, and the damage is really starting to take its toll.
Yeah, it's really starting to take its toll. And you watch the opponent walking gingerly on his leg, and one big tell that you're starting to really do well with your leg kicks is when your opponent starts to switch stances.
Right.
Watch for a stance switch very soon. Over and over, he's landing these big body kicks.
Every time these guys come together, man, you just hear the punches and everything landing. Both very powerful, very, very explosive.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
Oh, nice land with the knee. You see the taller fighter having no issue getting the limb to the target there. And they separate. He lands another knee there, DC. It doesn't always pay to be the taller fighter. In this instance, it most certainly did. Oh, flush knee lands to the body by the taller fighter. Oh man, I'm starting to feel bad for the canvas as he lands another takedown there.
He landed another takedown and he's doing it over and over again. What I am a massive fan of is his cardio, the ability to be able to keep this pace over and over as he hits these takedown attempts.
Oh, lands with the ground and pound strike. 30 seconds to go now. Volume strikes continue to rain down. His opponent pretty helpless there on the ground.
His opponent is helpless. He's been hurt, he's been battered, he's been beat, and now this guy's just trying to find the right time to land the strike that ends the fight.
Oh, he stunned him with that knee to the head. What a round. Second round underway. So he's really starting to put together some significant body shots here. These are going to take their toll as this fight goes up. Oh, I told you off the top he had the reach advantage, and you saw it right there with that punch.
Ooh, what a punch.
In and secures the takedown. Double leg takedown attempt here, and that one is true. Nice job there to enter and ultimately plant his opponent on the mat.
Now what does he do? That he's got his best shot off, finish the attack. Where does he go now from the top position?
All right, so back to the well with the elbows, and I guess if it's not broken, no need to fix it as he lands another combination.
He's getting in so close that it's hard to land anything else, so he's shortening up those elbows. They're landing beautiful.
Oh, nice job to reverse position.
Now he's gonna try to attack Kimura here. Oh man, that was slick.
Back to the feet now. Stuffs the takedown there. How good is his takedown defense? Watch the shot. All right, watch out for the setup here. DC, I know you don't pay your bets, but I'll bet you $100 he goes for another takedown here.
If I don't pay, then why are you betting me? I'll yell in the octagon and go, man, don't shoot, so that I can get paid. But if I'm betting, I'm trying to take the over. I believe that he's gonna get another takedown, so I will try to force you into...
Oh, nice scramble by him there. Takedown defense on point. He is a master in transition. Switching stances here. 3 minutes now to go in round two.
That knee hurt him.
An elbow!
What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Go finish this fight.
Huge block there.
Oh, he lands another.
Take him down, cut him. Take him down, cut him. Over and over, he's securing these takedowns.
All right, great position for him here. He's got the full mount. See if he can get that ground and pound going.
Oh, he's got to get it going, but he can't rush. A lot of times, guys get in the full mount and they rush. They get nervous. They're like, oh my goodness, I'm winning. Reality is, you're winning, but it can change in a matter of seconds because then they can be gone. He's got to drop his hips, be really heavy at the opponent's base, and then just start to work. Make the opponent give his back so that he can try to get his chokes off or find great ground and pound, but very patient ground and pound from such a dominant position.
Well, not good body language from his opponent here, DC. He's curled up.
No, he's exhausted. He's been beaten.
Sound strike on the ground. Oh, nice job working hard, posting, and getting back up. Well, a really good second round for him thus far. After a somewhat lackluster first round, he has found the rhythm and found his striking range. Now going to the judo throw, he ends up in side control. A lot of options for him here.
Yeah, he can either go ground and pound or he can chase submission.
Oh, back up again. You can't hold a good man down. Takedown defense holds up.
big body kick.
And he comes through with a big knee. Knee to the body. And they separate. Well, we'll see if he can turn this defense into offense, but he's doing a great job blocking shots here tonight.
As of right now, he's thinking more.
Big knee. Nice little shot, Lance.
See his opponent reacting.
So inside the open guard of his opponent. You gotta be careful playing around for too long here on the ground with this guy. Man, how fun is this to watch as he continues to dole out damage with the ground and pound?
Take it back to the days of guys like Mark Coleman, just beating people up in the ground and pound. This guy is a throwback fighter and he's very fun to watch.
Yeah, the Godfather would be proud. All right, let's look back at some of the action in that round, DC. What a high-level display of offensive wrestling.
I mean, this is a joy for me to watch. I enjoy it.
Last round, guys, you ready? You ready?
Crowd fired up, so are we. Third and final round. Range with the high kick. And there, Paul faints upstairs and lands flush to
the ground. Perfect. That is the reaction you're hoping to get. That one landed perfect in this fight. Maybe stop very soon.
Well, he's more than content to work off of his back, DC, where he has been a magician in his UFC career. All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's trying to hip escape.
Yeah, he's trying to hip escape or maybe look for a Kimura here.
All right, so he postures up here and now figures to rain down some ground strikes.
Yeah, the ground and pound will be a plenty from this position.
All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. Oh, nice job using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do now.
He's going to start looking to land big shots from the top.
Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining. He wiped him out!
Well, he's going to enjoy watching this one back. Let's take a look at the replay of the knockout just a moment ago.
It was right hand after right hand after right hand. Finally, he found the one that hit the exact sweet spot.
We send it inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer.